As Jessica lights the Davies chalice, we invite you to sit back, to relax, and to consider these words from Laura Bogle. We gather here to remember this is our home, but not just ours. The land we live on, the water we drink, this air we breathe, these old mountains that hold us steady to our ground, these forests that give us their healing green, these flowers that give us their beauty and fragrance, these fields that give us our daily bread, these stars that show us our place, the wilderness and the tame backyards, all of it our home. We remember the ancestors who have lived on this land and who have shaped it. We inherit their choices. We honor their animals and creatures that have made their home in this land, the ones here now and the ones that used to be here. We envision the future generations who will live on this land and let their voices fill our hearts. We gather here to remember this is our home, but not just ours. With your mic muted, please join us in singing "There Is More Love Somewhere."
This morning's reading comes from Linda Barnes' Blessings on Those Staying Home. We're staying home. Love has never asked this of us before. We're staying home. This is our gift to humanity. Let us wish each other well. For those who are staying home alone, I offer you this blessing. May you grow a deeper understanding of your own worth. Dear one, leaven the aloneness with gentle care, for this too shall pass. May you be blessed with peace and serenity. May you find the courage to reach out to another's voice and to remember that others need you too. May you be well. For those who are staying home together, I offer you this blessing. May you find moments of patience and grace in your relations. May you offer each other enough time apart, reassurance and space enough to cry, to safely rage, for this too shall pass. Then let peace come again into your home. May you see one another's whole self as a gift. May you be well. For those working from home, I offer you this blessing. May you remember to take breaks. May you find the means to relish your imperfection and the imperfection of others as evidence of our shared humanity. You are enough, even when there isn't enough. Make order in your days and then let it go. May you be well. For those staying home with children, I offer you this blessing. May you find humor and compassion in your days. There will be learning of a different kind, deeper, no doubt, unexpected for sure. May there be patience and forgiveness, and again, and again, and again, for this too shall pass. May you all remember the deep love that brought your family into being. May there be peace and understanding in your home. May you be well. May we be well. May it be so. And now I'm very happy to introduce again our speaker, Ariane Swann Odom. Thank you, Ariane.
Thank you. It is indeed a pleasure for my husband, Mark, and I to join you all virtually from our home. It is the first Sunday of the new year, 2021, and my first Zoom call with you, but this is actually my second year speaking with your congregation, and it is indeed a pleasure. Thank you for the invitation to speak today about my tribe, the Piscataway Conoy. Thank you for acknowledging that your very dwelling and house of worship are on ancestral land. Many of our tribal members still remain in this area, and many are Christians and Catholics from their initial encounters and indoctrination so many years ago. It is interesting to speak of history, to know who we are and how we survived, to tell our stories today. It is equally interesting to know how we are surviving today as a tribe, totally emerged and into our now blended society. How do we all blend yet hold on to our traditions, cultural norms, and heritage? We all have gained and lost many things due to this blending. Indeed, many battles and lives have been lost through the many years, and some more recently with the injustices that have affected many races of people. And we all have different stories, but it is the same story of struggle and survival. Today, many of us know that we celebrated 100 years ago that white women would have the right to vote. But that didn't change for others until the Civil Rights Movement. And then again, it didn't actually change for Native American women. It wasn't until later in the 60s that all states allowed Native Americans to vote. You must remember that we had to first become citizens of our own land. And as the gentleman spoke of earlier, we have many political issues that are being fought for all of us, so the struggle continues. Our tribe is still living in large numbers, as I said, here in Southern Maryland, but for many years had to be labeled either Black or white. And that was based on our skin tones. We are a rainbow tribe of many shades. And so you can imagine that that may have been rather difficult. Unfortunately, due to the segregation and it being harmful to actually acknowledge our race, it was not a sense of pride, but we had to keep our private rich heritage to ourselves. After a lot of money and a lot of hard work, in 2012, the state of Maryland recognized us as a tribe. That is almost unbelievable, being in the state of Maryland where so much of our rich initial history is from. We are still not federally recognized. I know some of you may wonder what that means. It means that you have the right to exist as a sovereign entity. And there are only approximately 600 tribes currently that have been given that federal recognition. Well, we don't need this recognition to know who we are, but it is a benefit to acknowledge our history and our cultural contributions. The federal recognition does provide financial benefits that are not afforded to state-recognized tribes. And one of those benefits is educational funding. And so with that, I say, the reason the Piscataway Conoy tribe started their own scholarships with the community colleges is because our children could not benefit from the federal grants and scholarships because of not having the federal recognition. So your gracious donations will go directly to the higher educational schools of the College of Southern Maryland and Prince George's Community College. They do not come to the tribe. We do not manage the money in any way. It goes directly to the schools, and the schools do it directly for the benefit of the Piscataway Conoy students who apply for such scholarships. Without any money to publicize or to promote those scholarships, we have only had private donations and mostly from other tribal members. So last year, your donation was so unexpected and so heartfelt, heartwarming, that we rejoiced in your kindness and your generosity. It was quite a surprise, and it was well received when other people of the tribe found out about it. The importance of education is crucial to our survival. And historically, we have always known that we were solely responsible for providing it to our children and future generations. But assimilation and survival have become the very reason so many of us have had such limited knowledge of our cultural ways. Everything possible, all the way up to death, has been done to our people throughout history to cause us to not speak our own language or perform our cultural ceremonies around others. Many people had to hide and deny their heritage in order to survive. So my great-grandfather, in order to survive, along with his brothers who were skilled bricklayers, built a one-room schoolhouse in Charles County to educate Piscataway children. In later years, in the 1940s, my mother would be educated in a one-room schoolhouse right up the road from your church on Allentown Road. In the 1950s, well, actually in 1950, the year itself, 1950, Fairmont Heights School opened, and my mother and her sister, who was a year younger, became part of the first graduating class. They were both awarded scholarships to colleges, my mother to Princess Anne on the Eastern Shore, now known as University of Maryland, Eastern Shore, and my aunt was given a full scholarship to Morgan. They were the first generation to go to college. My aunt would go on to become an educator, a teacher, and a principal. While the scholarships were to historically Black colleges with a rich history in educating and preparing people to live and function at higher levels of employment and in society, it was still segregated. Socially, it was difficult for many people who'd had no concept of our tribe or culture to accept them at their events on campus without wondering where they came from and what were they. Being of a fair to olive complexion and soft dark hair, they stood out. This was difficult for my mom and her sister after always being around family members and being educated in a one-room schoolhouse with relatives. They made friends eventually after answering the many questions of who they were and where they're from. Some accepted them, some did not. But by the 1960s and civil rights movements, people only saw Black or white. So much has changed, yet so much stays the same. I thank you for recognizing the land of our people that you live on and worship at. The neighborhood my mother grew up in off of Allentown Road was all Piscataway members. My grandparents did eventually move and built a house not that far away on Badger Avenue, a small neighborhood next to Clinton Grove Elementary. In that neighborhood, again, were all other Piscataway Conoy members. His brother built his house next door. His niece lived just down the street. Everyone looked out for everyone else. We shared our bounties with each other. Farming and hunting, as well as watermen, were traditions continued and shared with everyone. Skilled trades were shared to benefit others. They built each other's homes. They helped maintain them. They watched and cared for each other's kids and elders, quietly doing cultural traditions out of other people's sights. I too grew up in this same type of neighborhood in Upper Marlboro. My great uncle and aunt and numerous cousins from both sides of my parents surrounded and loved on us. As simple and basic as those concepts and values sound, if we could all still embrace them, oh, what a community we would have. To love and care for our young people together, no matter what they look like or where they're from, to educate them to do the same, oh, what a community we would have. To care for our elders and protect our vulnerable, to share the wealth, the wealth of knowledge, the financial wealth, and the very idea that our survival depends on each other. That would allow us to regain the love and respect for not just humans, but for the precious land we still have, to be good stewards of all these waterways. They give us life, our animals, our planets, our world, the balance we all need to not just survive, but to thrive and to pass it on to the future generations while being grateful to our ancestors. My dad is 85 years old. And at the end of this month, we will celebrate those 85 years and wisdom. He was the youngest of 15 children raised on the water and on a 25-acre farm. He demonstrated hard work, and he's taught us many things before sending me to Towson University. But one of the favorite sayings that I know and hold true that he's often said is what I'm going to leave you with today. Even a broken clock will tell you the right time of day at least twice. We all have something to give and share, and we are all right sometimes. You can do the right things. Choose to do the right things to be good to others, be good to our land, and the other gifts that the Creator has given us to enjoy. Be good stewards of our gifts. Leave this earth a better place than we found it for our next generations. I thank you in advance for your gracious invitation. This Sunday is very special, as I said, the first Sunday of the 2021 year. Your donations for our Piscataway Scholarship will impact for generations to come. And I am going to remain and available with your dialogue, with the questions that you all have at the end. I love your format, and I think that it is respectful and grateful of everyone's thoughts and opinions. And if there's any information that I can share with you afterwards to enlighten you or to encourage you, I look forward in doing so.
Thank you. I invite us now into a brief period of reflective silence. Let us enter that silence together.